It was standing room only at the Pearl Young Theater at NASA's Langley Research Center for the final launch of the space shuttle. In the crowd, a number of Langley engineers who helped develop and test the shuttle before it ever flew.
And it was kind of exciting because
Jim Arrington helped establish the aerodynamic database that's been crucial for orbiter reentry.
I couldn't believe it's been 30 years since I was here to watch the first launch, and now 30 years later I'm here to watch the last launch. I guess I have mixed feelings. When it was first launched, I had expectations that it was the beginning of space exploration, and it would just be advanced, and we would just have routine flight into space, certainly within 30 years.
Also on hand, dozens of summer interns, none of whom were born when the first shuttle launched. But both generations were equally attentive as the clock counted down.
All three engines up and burning. 2, 1, 0, and liftoff. The final liftoff of Atlantis. On the shoulders of the space shuttle, America will continue the dream.
Everyone sat in their seats until Atlantis was high in the sky, in orbit after main engine cutoff. They knew this was something they might never see again.
It's the only vehicle we've got can do what that can do. It can carry one hell of a payload, 60,000 pounds. That's a big payload, and it takes it right on up to the space station. So I don't see any sense in retiring the shuttle.
24 seconds into the flight.
But retirement is just a few short weeks away. NASA's space plan now? Work on systems to allow humans to leave low Earth orbit and explore more of the universe.
40 seconds into the flight.